Hello, I'm Dave Clayton, and in this video for Astute Graphics, we are going to be looking at our brand new AG Architect panel, or our AG Architect tool, and this is part of Stylism. If you've seen our recent videos on YouTube, you will have seen in VectorScribe we added an extend path functionality. Now, this has been taken further, and we've added it to Stylism as an actual AG Architect tool, and this is where we can apply extended lines to segments, to shapes, to compound paths, and we can have full control over it. So rather than me talk about it, let's have a look and see what AG Architect actually does. I've created a selection of shapes and lines here, and what I'm going to do is select all of them. I'll go through each one just to sort of explain why each one is different and how it applies to AG Architect. But for now, we've selected all of them, and what we're going to do is come over to the AG Architect panel. If you haven't got it open, just come up to Window, go to Astute Graphics, and you'll see AG Architect at the top there. And just click on that and the panel will open. So now we've got the panel open. There are actually no preferences for this. We just have Detach All Effects, Remove All Effects, and Reset to Default. So we'll just click on that to begin with. And you'll see here in the panel, we've got some things that are already checked, and we've got some values in some of these input boxes here. So what we're going to do with everything selected, we're just going to click on Apply AG Architect. And what that's going to do is apply these extended paths, these extended lines to this artwork. Now you'll see some of them have got sharp corners, some of them have got curves, some have got circular shapes as well. So let's just have a quick look through and see what each of these settings is going to do when we apply it to each of these shapes. So the first one's quite simple. If we've got segments with curved lines or straight lines, we can decide whether these extended lines appear. So let's just turn off curved. And we can see here, if you look at this shape here, there was an extension coming out of here. Let's just tick that again, and you'll see that it reappears. So that means we can say only apply to curved segments or not. If we come over to straight and uncheck that, then you're going to see that all of our straight edged lines and paths and shapes are no longer going to display the extension. However, the circular ones will still show the AG Architect lines. So let's just click that and turn them back on again. Now this next setting, only if angle is. So this means if we know that we've got a specific path that is a set angle, so I know this one over here is 45 degrees. So what I'm going to say is, going to check that and say only if angle is 45 degrees, and you'll see straight away that we've got an extension here on this line. We've also got an extension here and an extension here, because these three lines are all 45 degrees. I've got a plus or minus 1 degree here just to give me a little bit of tolerance, but that's if you've got a very specific angle. It just limits the extensions to those angled segments or paths. So let's just turn that off again, and we'll go and select all of our shapes again. Uncheck that, and we'll get our extensions back on all the shapes. Another thing we've got here is smooth and corner joints. So if I turn off smooth, you'll see that anything with a smooth curve, like say on these squares down here, it's going to turn them off because it knows not to add the extension to those curved corners. Then if I turn off the other one, then we're going to lose it on our sharp pointed edges, as you can see when I turn it on and off. We also have open path endpoints. So if I uncheck that, you're going to see these paths that do have open endpoints are no longer going to show the extension. The same thing with holes in compound paths. If we come down here, this is a compound path, so I can tell it not to apply to the circle, but only to the outside edge. So you've got some control up here that gives you the options to decide where these extensions will appear. If we move to the bottom half of the panel, we can see that we've got some options on how these extensions are displayed. So for a start, we've got positioning. So we can say below original, above original, or replace originals. If we do above, that's going to sit on top of the lines, and obviously if we do below, it's going to go to the back of the paths. You can't see that at the moment because they're all black, but if we also come to replace original, what it's going to do is actually remove the original paths and just leave us with our extensions, which can be quite cool depending on what you're working on. So let's just go back to above original for now. Now the other thing here we got is length. Now we can have an absolute length, which we can decide on. So at the moment it's 72 pixels. I can make that much bigger. So let's double that. And you'll see that the lines extend. And if we make it shorter, say 20, it'll make them much shorter in length. We can also do it so that it's relative to the line that it's applied to. So if we want it to be kind of 25%, that will mean, as you'll see down here, these outer ones are slightly longer because this shape is bigger, but the ones inside are slightly smaller because that shape is smaller. So let's just go back to absolute. The other thing here now is let's go and extend those again so we can see what we're doing. We go back to 50 pixels. Now I can apply a color to the stroke or to the color of the extension. So I can either specify color, and what it will do is it will take the color from the swatch here. So if I make this yellow, I can tell them all to be yellow. It's also taking the weight of the lines that I've got as well. But if I use specify weight, then I can just not affect the color, but I can just affect the weight here. So I can increase and decrease. And I can also do specify both. So I can actually change the color and the weight of them. So if we change this back and go to, say, a green color, let's make it a nice light green so we can see it. And we can bump up that stroke as well. So you can see that it extends beyond the weight that you originally had, so that you can see that we can actually adjust the weight of that as well. So let's just pop that back to 1 point for now. One other setting here is we can actually say use original. So what that's going to do is just take the original color of each line, and it's just going to apply that extension, and it's going to adopt the color that already exists. So let's have a look at this randomize. So if we tick this, we can go ahead and click through some different seeds like so, and you can see they adjust. If we wanted to, we can actually alt click or alt option click, and we can put in a particular seed. Now highlight this and command C to copy, because if you like this you may want to put that back in again. So we'll click OK. Let's just say we go through a few more seed variations, and then we come back and go, all right, we want the one we just created ourselves. We can just alt option click, paste it back in there, and it will take us back to the seed that we originally applied that we liked. So they're the settings on AG Architect. What we're going to do now is use this and apply it to some shapes and to some letters to show you how you can be creative with the tool. Also, before we go on, if you want to, you can actually detach all of these. So we can either remove all of the AG Architect effects, or we can actually detach them, which is like expanding them. So once we do this, we've now got these parts individual. So you can see here, if we just zoom in, you can see that now this is now an individual path. So you could actually go and apply another AG Architect to the top of this if you want to keep going and adding and adding. It just depends what you want to create. So that's the end of this overview video. Let's have a look at some creative stuff we can do with this tool.